Which revolutionary had to sign the Declaration of Independence just to prove he was not a loyalist? Hi, Founder fans, Jason here, and today's founder is a man named William Hooper. Now, William Hooper grew up in Boston, and he got his law degree there, but in the late 1760s, there were a lot of lawyers in Boston, and Hooper decided to relocate to North Carolina, where he opened up a successful practice, and by just 30 years old, was appointed as Attorney General of North Carolina. In this position, he worked very closely with the royal governor, and in the early 1770s, there was an uprising in what was then Western North Carolina, but today we would think more Central North Carolina. And this group called themselves the Regulators, and they were essentially, in very brief, protesting certain laws being passed by the coastal elites over on the coast of North Carolina. I know we don't think of North Carolina as coastal elites nowadays, but at that point, that was certainly the issue. Now, this rebellion of the Regulators was suppressed by the royal governor, with the help of many future founders, including, of course, William Hooper, who had, as Attorney General, responsibility of prosecuting many of these people. As the revolution neared, this got Hooper accused of being a loyalist. Now, once the revolution really started getting going, Hooper was slow and hesitant to join the rebels, but once the royal governor dissolved the colonial assembly, which Hooper had just been elected to the year before, well, that's when he became a rebel himself and sided with the Patriots. Now, the government was essentially shut down, but committees of correspondence essentially were running the show. And even though there was technically no government, Hooper worked very hard to make sure that North Carolina still operated as if it did have a government. And this impressed his friends, the coastal elites that were running the show. This impressed those people and his friends, and they decided to send him to the First Continental Congress, where Hooper signed the Articles of Association, also known as the Continental Association, which, of course, is the first major document of the American Revolution, and called for the boycott, among other things, of British goods. 2 years later, William Hooper still in the Continental Congress, where he signs the Declaration of Independence. Hooray! And this pretty much seals the deal that he is not a loyalist, because he signed the Declaration of Independence. But North Carolina ran into some trouble. A year later, Hooper decides to resign and go back to his private practice. But this was a problem because, as I said, there was some trouble in North Carolina. Wilmington, his home, was taken over by the British, and unfortunately he could not go back to work, nor could he go back to his house. He ended up being separated from his family for almost a year and a half. He didn't see his wife and children, and he was forced to rely on the kindness of his friends for clothing and shelter and food. Now, fortunately, after the war ended, things went back to normal, and Hooper did enjoy a successful life, but he never returned to public office, partially because he never really shook the whole "I think he was a loyalist" thing, and also because he had so much trouble and had lost so much during the war that he had to take the time to rebuild his life. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. I certainly enjoyed making it for you. If you did like it, please hit like and don't forget to subscribe. Videos like this I put out 5 days a week, and we have an awesome live one on Saturday where we chit-chat about articles I wrote in the past week. So please, feel free to join us, and I will see you with another founder tomorrow.